Hi, assalamu alaikum and a very good morning. So now we are in chapter 3, electrochemistry, focusing on the subtopic of 3.3 electrolytic cell, part 1 of this video. So in this video, we're going to learn on how to draw the electrolytic cell, as well as explaining the operation of the electrolytic cell by comparing it with the galvanic cell that we have learned in the subtopic of 3.1. Alright, and we're also going to look into the factors, which is the three factors, that can influence the selective discharge of a species at the electrode. So ada tiga faktor yang mempengaruhi pemilihan species di electrode tersebut. Alright. So the first factors is the standard reduction potential, which is the SRP value, or we also going to look into the electrochemical cell. Alright, where the electrochemical cell, you have to memorize that. And for second is the concentration of the species, kepekatan spesies, dan yang ketiga adalah nature of the electrolyte, which is the whether it is an active electrolyte or the inert electrolyte. Alright, so we're going to look into these three factors independently, and without any further ado, let us start. So, in this video, you're going to look into the differences between the galvanic cell and electrolytic cell first. So galvanic cell is something that you have learned in the subtopic of 3.1, where the electrolyte is divided into two beakers and they are connected with a salt bridge. However, in the electrolytic cell, it happens in the same electrolyte, which is the copper chloride solution, and it is attached with a dry cell here instead of a voltmeter. So the dry cell here will provide energy to the system, and this will be having a transformation of energy from electrical to chemical energy. And for the electrolyte itself, the electrode here will be depending on the terminal of the dry cell. So if this one is positive, then the electrode going to be positive. If this one is negative, then the electrode here going to be negative. In the electrolyte itself, the positive terminal will be known as anode. Meanwhile, the negative terminal will be referring as cathode. And for the solution here, we can see that the copper, they have copper 2 plus ion and chloride minus ion. And the solution here means it is dissolved in water, H2O, where the H2O have its component of H plus and OH minus ion. So we have all of this component in this same electrolyte. Okay, since anode carries a positive charge and cathode will gonna carry a negative charge, the anion will be attracted to the anode. Okay, because anion is a negative charge, will be attracted to the positive terminal. So anion here is chloride and hydroxide ion. Meanwhile, for the cation, positive charge will be attracted to the negative charge of cathode, which is copper 2 plus and H plus. And anode is the place where oxidation occurs. Where, if you were to remember in part of 3.1, an ox echoes a lead down, it means that oxidation happens at anode. And red cat, kucing merah, maknanya reduction berlaku dekat cathode. Alright? And this is the direction of the electron flow, which is from anode going to cathode. Alright? Now, we're going to learn about the factors that affecting the product of electrolysis. So, as mentioned, there are three factors altogether, which is the SRP value, concentration of ions, and the type of electrode used. For the type of electrode used, we have the inert electrode, for example, carbon and platinum, where it does not take part or does not participate in the redox reaction of the cell. Meanwhile, for active electrode, which is zinc and copper, dia akan terlibat dalam redox reaction of the cell. It will be participating. Okay, and without going any further, these are the equation that you have to memorize to make your life easier, which is for anode and cathode. This is the oxidation of water, and this one is the reduction processes of water. So this is quite a popular discharge of the water. So to make your life easier, it is better for you to memorize this equation. Alright? So let's look into the first factor first, which is the standard reduction potential. So, in order to select species to discharge, we need to use the standard reduction potential, or we can use the electrochemical series. So basically, they are the same thing, but if this thing will not be given during the exam, so the best thing that you can do is to look at the electrochemical series. So you can use a mnemonyms or mnemonics in order to memorize the the electrochemical series as what you learn in high school. For me, I can say that kalau nak cari mangkuk Aladdin, Zon Felda sediakan pembantu haram, cuba hubungi, which is Mercury, abang aku, which is Aurum at the last. So the one that is below here, which have a positive value, will be selected for discharge. So usually water will be selected for discharge, unless when there is copper or silver metal that's involved, then copper and silver will be selected for the discharge. All right, and basically the ECS here is constructed from the table here. So the more negative one's gonna be up, and the more positive one gonna be down. Okay, and for the cation, we will select the one which has a more positive value, which is silver, copper, and water. Okay, because hydrogen here is the component of water. Meanwhile, for anion, it's basically the reverse. We need to take the more negative SRP value, which is the one at the above here, which is the easier of discharge increases from bottom to low, from bottom layer to the upper layer. So the water here is easier to discharge, all right, at the anion part. Okay, so these are the things that you need to know. So I will suggest you to memorize the electrochemical series in order to help you to understand the electrolytic cell better. Alright, so now let's look into the first factor. So the first factor, if we were to have a dilute NaCl solution. So the dilute NaCl solution basically has a ion of Na plus, Cl minus, and solution here refers to water, which is the component of H plus and or H minus. Okay, for the anion, we're gonna have the chloride ion and also the hydroxide ion, and this will move towards the anode. Meanwhile, for the cation, we will have a cation, which is the sodium plus and also the H plus ion, which refers to the water here. Okay, so the idea here is we need to select chloride ion minus or hydroxide ion that will be selected for discharge. Or at the cation, which one gonna be selected for discharge? So this is the question. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna look back at the electrochemical series. So if you were to see here, and at the cathode here, which is the cation, the H plus gonna be selected for discharge because H plus is lower. Meanwhile, for the Na plus is gonna be up here. So it will not be selected for discharge. So we know that H2O gonna be reduced here. Meanwhile, for the anion part, the upper species, it is more easier for it to discharge. So as what you can see here, the hydroxide will be selected for discharge instead of the chloride. Okay, so it's between the oxidation of water and reduction of water. So that is why I asked you to memorize this equation, because I think it's going to be a quite popular equation in the electrolysis processes. Alright, so let's do that. So at that thought, you know that the water going to be reduced to form hydrogen gas as well as two hydroxide ion. Meanwhile at anode, the water will be oxidized to form oxygen gas and the 4H plus aqueous plus 4 electron. And in order to make the overall cell equation, we can cancel out the electron here. However, this have two electrons, but here got four electrons. So we have to multiply this equation by two. Okay, so once we do that, we will have 4H2O liquid plus 4 electron produces 2 mole of hydrogen gas and 4 mole of hydroxide ion. So 4 electrons here can cancel out and 4 electrons here can cancel out. So what we left is 4 plus 2 mole of water, we will get 6 mole of water liquid, produces oxygen gas, 2 mole of hydrogen, 4 hydroxide ion and 4 H plus ion. And if you were to see here, this thing can form water, OH minus ion and H plus ion. So we will get 4H2O liquid here. And liquid water here and water here can be cancelled out because 6 on the reactant side and 4 on the product side. So we will have balance on the reactant side as 2. So lastly, we will get 2H2O liquid produces oxygen and 2 mole of hydrogen gas. So that's our overall equation. And this is the E naught values. So if you were to add up, we will get negative 2064. Alright, so this will be usually given in the question. If not, we have to find it in the list of the SRP value. Alright. So now let's look into the next factor, which is the factor of concentration. So here it's clearly stated that it is a concentrated NaCl solution. So NaCl solution contains Na+, chloride minus ion and H2O species, which is the H+ and OH- ion. So as before, the chloride, the N naught, which is the positive terminal, will pull the anion, which is chloride minus and hydroxide ion. For the cathode, it will be attracting the sodium plus ion and H plus ion. So we need to be dependent on the electrochemical series here again. So for the anode, we will be selecting the hydroxide ion to be selected for discharge. Meanwhile, for cathode, it's gonna be the H plus because it is lower. So the lower it is in the cation species, then it will be selected for discharge. Okay, this is what you will assume it to be. However, because it is concentrated, the chloride minus ion will be selected for discharge instead of the hydroxide ion. Okay. So Cl- will be selected instead of hydroxide. Meanwhile here, even though Na plus is concentrated, the Na plus here is a reactive metal. So reactive metal will not be discharged. Okay? So for Na plus here, even though it is concentrated, but we don't take the Na plus because it is a reactive metal and it will not be discharged. So for the cation part, we will stay with the H plus. Alright. So now at the anode, the chloride ion will be discharged, will be selected. And for the cathode here, the H2O will be reduced. So let's look into the equation. So the reaction involved is anode, which is the chloride minus ion. When it is oxidized, it will form chlorine gas. And because it got two chlorine here, it need to be balanced out and it will produce two electrons here. So the charge is 2 minus, here also 2 minus. So the balance is, the charge is balanced. Meanwhile, for cathode, it is the reduction of water where it is the equation that I asked you to memorize. Alright, so here we can make up the overall cell reaction by cancel off the electrons here. So finally, when we cut off the two electrons, we'll get 2 Cl- equals plus 2 H2O liquid produces chlorine gas, hydrogen gas, and two hydroxide ions. And the E naught cell will be adding up both of these together. We will get negative 2.9 volt. So observation that we can say is, at the anode, the chlorine gas is liberated, which is greenish yellow color. Meanwhile, for the cathode, we can say that the hydrogen gas is being released, which where the hydrogen is in the colorless. Also, we can see that because it produces hydroxide ion, then the solution appears to be alkali. Alright, now let's look into the third factor. So for the third factor, it basically the same setup but uses the different type of electrode. Okay, so one is the inert electrode, which is graphite. Okay, and active electrode, for example, copper. Okay, so they uses the same electrolyte, which is copper sulfate solution. So copper sulfate solution containing copper 2+, sulfate ions, and H2O species. So the cathode will gonna go be the cathode will be attracting the cation, which is copper 2+ and H2O. Meanwhile, the anode will be attracting sulfate ion and H2O. So in usual cases where we use inert electrode, where before this factor 1 and factor 2, we are using the graphite electrode or the carbon electrode or the platinum electrode, which is all inert. So for this case, we will be dealing it as usual, where at the cathode part, we will be selecting the copper 2+, because copper 2+ is lower than water. So copper 2+ will be selected to discharge at cathode, where it undergo reduction to form copper solid. Okay, from copper 2+ aqueous to copper solid. And at anode, the H2O will be selected because it is easier to be discharged. And this is the equation for the water that I asked you to memorize. Liquid and aqueous here. Meanwhile, this one is a gas phase. So the phase is also compulsory. Meanwhile, for the active electrode, our product going to be a little bit different. So for cathode, we have copper 2+, discharge to form copper solid. So it's basically the same. However, this situation is differs at the anode part. So neither sulfate ion or H2O will be selected. So bukan sulfate ion dan juga bukan air yang dipilih, tetapi copper itu sendiri, copper metal is the one that are being involved or participate in the redox reaction, because as mentioned, active electrode participate, dia terlibat dalam redox reaction. So at anode, the copper solid will undergo oxidation to form copper 2+ and produces 2 electrodes. And as a result, copper electrode here will dissolve and here will become thickened because it keep on produces copper. Meanwhile here, it will get thinner and thinner and thinner. Alright, so that's the third factor. Okay, I think that's all the three factors that we wanted to look at. And I think that's the finish of this video. So I think see you again in the next video. Bye.